Welcome back for Saturday's video. It's been a while, so we are going to do a new kits video. It's new kit time. It's new kit time. We're going to start off. I'm going to show you off personal stash stuff, and then I'll reset the desk every time. We'll show off what everybody else has sent in this month. First up, for personal stuff, I picked up this diorama building set called Fortifications B. It's kit number SIB04. It's a big multi-layer set, and what I thought this would be cool for is showing off some cool model cars and stuff. It's got a base down here. It can be reconfigured, but I thought, you know, down here, if I can add some LED lights on a railing, we could maybe take some cool pictures of model cars and change that up a little bit instead of just the black screen or that shop that I have on there. So that's why I picked that one up. We'll start to see that on the show in some pictures. I have been looking for this kit forever. I saw it in a hobby shop about 100 miles north of me. Saw it a couple times this summer. Didn't pick it up. Looked on the internet. Couldn't find a better price. So a few weeks ago, I was on a little tour of the UP in Michigan that I love up to Lake Superior. And on the way home, I said, today's the day. If there's a parking spot in front of that hobby shop, I'm going to go in there. I'm going to buy the Unimog. And I did. Revell Germany's Level 4, 100 or 1/24 scale kit, Unimog, Mercedes-Benz, Winterdienst. It's a snow plow. So I want to build this one this winter at some time. Like I did the old plow truck for my dad. I don't know if I'm going to paint it orange or what I'm going to do with it, but that's what I want to do with it. So that's why I grabbed that one. Also, from Hobby Lobby, snatched up some Star Wars kits. They run all their kits at like 40% off every other week. So don't rush in there when it's regular price. Just wait till the next week. It's going to be 40% off. Snag some Star Wars kits. They got this beautiful Bandai X-Wing Starfighter Red 5. Very, very nice models. It's from the Rise of Skywalker. They're always releasing new Star Wars kits. So I had to grab that one because Star Wars, I just love sci-fi. And then we got the Red Squadron X-Wing Fighter, includes a 1/72 scale and 1/144 scale. So it's got two kits inside the box. You can weather them up. You can decorate them. They've got display boxes and they're 40 bucks normal price, but at 40% off makes for a great deal. Of all the places I would never think to buy a model kit, I found the Mandalorian at Target. Yes, Target, for the fancy people that don't like Walmart. Found it on their website. I hear the luckiest people on the planet that live in cool cities where their Target isn't extremely lame not only get the 1/12 scale Mandalorian figure, but they've also got the Razor Crest, the very small ship from the Mandalorian, and they're in the stores. I can't believe that. I'm not that lucky. I was only able to get this online through their website. That's where I found it. Use my Target card, get 5% off, which pretty much eliminated the sales tax, shipped for free right to my door, and that is that. I'm going to reset the table with another sponsor's items. I'll be right back. What do we got next? Well, we got some stuff from different kinds of vendors, and they want me to review it on the channel, and I said, yeah, because why not? It's the workshop, not just model workshop. This channel started out reviewing tools and outdoor equipment and home goods. I evolved into models because that was my big hobby. The models have kind of taken over, but we're always going to bring it back and do the original stuff. And if you don't like those videos, you don't have to watch them. And if you do like seeing cool new stuff, go ahead and check those videos out. From Chemo, two of their cordless power tools, 20 volt cordless reciprocating saw. If you're familiar with Milwaukee tools, they call this a hacksaw, because it's built more like a hacksaw, but it's also an electric reciprocating saw. They sent over their cordless kit for that. We're gonna be checking that bad boy out. We're gonna be using it. And they sent over their cordless ratchet wrench. They didn't even spell, it's a wrench. It's not a wrench, it's a wrench. We got some Chinese English there. So we're gonna be checking out those cordless tools from Chemo. We thank them for sending those over. Banggood's got some stuff you just saw on Friday. They sent over a fire table. I didn't even know they carried stuff like that, and they do. And some of this other stuff I didn't know they carried either. This little tool here, this box is very heavy. This is a micro-sized screwdriver. It's nowhere near the size of this. It's the size of a large ballpoint pen, and it's got a gajillion attachments. It's completely cordless, got a stand to sit in, charges up quickly, and it's got all these little attachment tools and everything and a little storage case in here. It's called the Wow Stick. make your own jokes on that one. It's a neat little tool. I've charged it up and used it a couple times. We're going to be reviewing that on the show. Also, you've got so much stuff that gets dusty, and you're spending money on all those air tanks and all that other garbage and spending a fortune and throwing those things away. They're like a dollar at the dollar store, but they're $5 for one that lasts more than three squirts. And these things are kind of cool. They're air dusters. They have two speeds. They produce a lot of air. You're going to see it in the video. They've also got this down tube, which has a brush on it that you can attach two different tubes and brush and dust your models and clean things up around the house and dry off small items. They sent the Super Duty 15,000 amp or 1.5 amp hour, 15,000 milliamp model. So we're going to be checking that one out and review that. And for my shed, I thought you guys would like to see, so I said they could send this one as well when they asked. It is a cordless solar, it's a solar, so you don't have to plug it into house power, rechargeable LED light for like inside a work shed or a security light in a basement or something. The power goes out, or if you don't want to run power cords out to your machine shed or storage shed like I have, which is like 90 feet from the house. I don't want to dig a trench and run house power and install a circuit breaker in the basement for it and all that. You just put this near the roof, you hang that light from the center. It's even got a remote to let you control the different colors of the light, how dim and how long it runs. It's got a 9-foot cable to run to the outside of the shed and charge it. We're gonna be checking that out and see if it works. And now, this thing. Elegoo asked if they could send over, just because they watch the channel and they're like, hey, you like new tools? We got a new tool for you. And I'm like, all right, what is it? We wanna send you our resin 3D printer. This is out now. It's supposed to be the newest style. It's like less than $200, which I wasn't even aware of. I don't know anything about 3D printers. I wasn't aware they were less than $200 now. They sent it over. They sent over their polymer resins, their water washable resins. It's supposed to dry with like UV light. I've got to figure this thing out and then get a video done where at least I can 3D print something and see how it all works. I don't know how these work. I don't know what the learning curve is like, but I'm going to do it for you. I'm going to do it for me over here and see what it's like. So we thank Elegoo for sending that over. These are available right now if you want to pick one up and try it yourself. Elegoo.com is who ships it. It stands upright. It's pretty tall. We'll be able to make like custom model parts and headers and whatever, as long as you can get the 3D file or make your own. So I can't wait to test this one out. I'm going to switch over to some models and I'll be right back. We're going to do two sponsors in one, since there's a lot of room on the desk for these. Atlantis Models, always sending out the retro stuff, the awesome kits. While they sent over, we're going to see them for the first time on the channel. Submarines. We got the USS Nautilus, a foot long model. We got the USS Gato fleet submarine. That one's almost 16 inches long. Now we're going to unbox the Nautilus in a review, probably just quickly glue it together so you can see it. The full build in the video coming up is going to be of the Gato, because on the box it says here, all the submarines that can be built in the box with the decals for the drum, the silver sides, the croaker, the cod, the cobia, the cavala, and the Gato. The cobia is the one I'm going to build because I've actually been on the cobia submarine, got to take a tour of it in Manitowoc, Wisconsin. I can't wait to build this guy up. I've never built a sub before on the channel, and we will probably put the Nautilus together. I just won't paint and decal it or anything. Also from Atlantis, the 57 Chevy Funny Car. Tom, Mongoose McEwen, 125th scale, this thing, or 124th, 124th, my mistake, from Atlantis. Check that out. I know you guys love the dragsters. I know you love checking out the Atlantis kits. They're all kinds of retro goodness. They give you the whole story here. They got awesome box art on the back. They got a color picture of a built model as a guide. So I know you want to see that one built up. I know the funny car videos do well. I'm going to do those up. Moving those to the side, from Machine Planet. They sent two of these over. It had to have been by a mistake. They're the exact same kit. So you know what that means. If you don't just watch, I only watch muscle car kits, that's fine. If those are the only videos you want to watch, and you miss a lot of cool stuff when you do that. What you're going to miss in this video is, you'll be able to enter, since I've got two of these, I'm going to give one away. I'm going to build one. It's this awesome mechanical robot in one of those toolboxes again that you can move around with motion and stuff. It looks kind of like a transformer. They sent it over for a full build. Comes in these awesome toolboxes like you've seen those other videos if you've been lucky enough to watch them. I ended up with two of the exact same thing. So I'm going to build one in a video, and in that video, I'm going to give away a code word, and then I'm going to box one of these up and mail it to one of you loyal viewers who likes to watch every video I put out because you like to have fun. I'm going to set up for the next sponsor and be right back. From my bros, Jack and Kirk, over at Model Roundup, the best packed models in the business. When these guys send you something, you know it's going to arrive in great shape unless UPS uses it as a wheel chock. They sent over four sweet, sweet kits. We got the Richard Petty 72 Dodge Charger. This is in 1/25th scale, using the bodies of the other Chargers I built on the show with the new decals for the 43 there, those the wraparound like so. Now on this one, you can paint that. The decals are available to do the vermilion as well. We all know the Salvino's kits build up so nice. This new Charger is no different. They build up beautifully. So at least we'll get an unboxing of this one since I've built numerous other versions of that Charger on the show already. And from Atlantis, now yes, these are from Atlantis model kits, but Model Roundup sent them over, so we're going to build these for Model Roundup and link over to them. It is Tom Daniels, because Atlantis is big into the Tom Daniels kit, they got the license. The Groovy Grader. Ah, look at that thing. That is so cool. Giant blown V8 hanging off the back, we got a belly blade, we got all kinds of chrome parts. So this is going to be a two-part video. It's going to be in one video, split into two things. We got the Unreal roller with that awesome corrugated roof on it, the huge chrome steel rollers. That's a lot of chrome that I don't want to mess with. This one doesn't have a lot of chrome, so I can totally mess with the kit. What I'm thinking in a video, give me your opinion. I build the Groovy Grader, and I give it the HPI guy's weathered treatment, all right? We rust it up. We crust it up, we fade the paint, we got some oil dripping off that big 454 wrap motor, like it's kind of been neglected. And the Unreal roller, we build out of the box, I high gloss the green, we shine up that 496 engine, we polish up the chrome, and we make that thing look showroom new, like it's going to a farm and show out in the country there. So that's what I'm thinking towards that. Give me your ideas towards those. And this absolute unit of a kit, Revell Germany's 1/24th scale, 40 centimeters long, enormous Krupp Titan SWL80. This thing is massive. I saw it available. They sent it over. They've got these for sale right now in an extremely limited quantity. The kit number is 07559. If you want to watch me build this kit and then build it yourself, I highly recommend you go to Model Roundup right now and buy it and get it. This is going to get a full build up on the channel, but they have so few of these, they're going to sell out. And the way shipping is from Revell these days, you don't know when they're going to show up again. It's not a cheap kit, but it's enormous and it's worth it. It's absolutely exquisite and I can't wait to build it. So we thank them for sending that over. That is not a small amount of coin to ship to someone to build up for a show. I'm going to switch over and we'll be right back. Last but certainly not least, this is probably the part that gets you the most excited on here. Round 2 Models is knocking it out of the park with all the kit releases in 2021. They're keeping your wallet empty and your bench full with all these awesome kits. They're even releasing all these deluxe decal packs. You've been seeing how awesome their decals are in so many of their videos. Well, now they're putting out wood grain decals, checker flag decals, flames, sponsors, tow cars, the old pro, the outsider, all these decals that you've seen in the other kits, the Rat Finks, and all that, they are sending out now as individual packages so you can build up your own custom kits and enjoy it. So now we can start seeing on some of the round 2 builds, I can start using custom decals so I can start putting stuff on kits. Also, as far as plastic, just out of the park, like I said. First up, 66 Ford Fairline 427, 1/25th scale. Look at that Savage. That is a beautiful kit there. Looks like it's going to be a 2-in-1. That looks pretty stock right there. We got the Dragger right there. lets you know of all the option parts in the kit. I like that. Look at that little scoop on there. That's pretty sexy. Big old decal sheet, chrome side molding so you don't have to paint it on. That is awesome. All the parts in there, that one's getting a full build. You know it is. I never even knew this kit existed. All right, I'm not extremely knowledgeable on kit history. This is the Sand Cat 125th scale dune buggy dragster kit. It's got like double grasshopper RC car style tires in the back, a massive Hemi, a guy sitting in front of it, probably trying just not to die, a big flag for the dunes. I mean, it's really cool. I don't know anything about it. It looks like they include a cool Sand Cat decal on there. It says free full color display stand plus the cat decal. This thing's got a lot of stuff in the box, so we'll be building that one up. I got to check out that display stand, see what that's about. You saw me build the 64 Cutlass with the drop top as a rusted car. Here we go. 64 442 Cutlass, 125th scale, 3-in-1 hardtop customizing kit. Lets you build it up in one of three different ways. Huge decal sheet in that kit. Lets you decide what are the parts you want to use. Double-sided red line or gold Firestone Supreme tires printed on each side. 442 engine block and air cleaner. They say it's all new. Looking forward, I think I should do this one as a pretty pristine car instead of weathering it up since we already did one. I know you guys have been waiting for this one patiently. Bruce Larson's 74 Pro Stock Vega USA 1 Legends of the Quarter Miles from MPC. I'm not exactly sure when the release date is on this one, but since I have a production kit, you know that it is not that far behind. And it is coming up soon. Nice decals to help with that paint job on there. Really, you saw me build up Grumpy's Vega. You're going to see me build the USA 1 to go right next to it on the shelf. We're still not done. Round 2's got so many cool car kits coming out for you car guys. 65 Bonneville Sport Coupe. It's an authentic model. It's a 3-in-1 fastback customizing kit in the 125th scale. Check it out. Look at this thing. That is a custom cruiser. You got complete front end custom on that thing. You've got this awesome decal sheet. They're really getting involved with letting you guys pick the kind of water slides that you want on there, and they listen to your advice. We got flames. We got these really cool, like, ghost style stripings. Those would look cool on even a non-custom car. So we're going to be throwing that bad boy together on the show. You watch me build the Snaptite Speed Racer Mach 5. Well, we got the full assembly kit. Now, you were talking in that one about, oh, where's the saws it used to have? Where's that? This is where they are. And the actual assembly kit, the plastic kit, the glue together, paint yourself kit is where you get the engine detail, the saws, the lifts that work. That's why you guys that were freaking out in that video, I said, calm down. It's two separate kits, man. You can see the engine in this one, the blades and all that right from the cartoon. So don't worry. This one's coming up. You're going to get to see the Mach 5 that you know. And for the sci-fi guys, Space 1999, the Comlock, the stun gun. I don't know anything about this show, but you know that I like models. I've built other Space 1999 models. These look pretty cool. She's holding it like that. He's holding it like that. Good thing it's on the box topper. I would have no idea how any of this works. I still think it's cool. It's like some sort of four-barreled phaser with buttons on it. And this thing looks like an early cellular phone. Maybe it's a flute. She's talking into it like a microphone. Obviously, it's called a Comlock and stun gun, so we know what they do. So I've got to try those out, see what those are like. All kinds of cool detail on the back. Jamie over at Round 2 is a big Space 1999 fan. And the last kit up from Model Rectifier Corporation sent over Academy's God Phoenix. Now, you recognize this from Gotcha Man, Battle of the Planets. You saw me build the new God Phoenix from the cartoon, the newer version. This is the one that a lot of us old folks remember from the cartoon. The older style, the one that looks like the bird, the one with all the colorful characters and their vehicles. Well, they sent this one over. It's got a base. It lights up like the other one, so I'm looking forward to putting this one together. Supposed to be molded in color and need minimal paint, just like the last one, so it should be a very easy build. These are coming out into the United States. If they're not here already, they will be very soon. Look them up. They always sell out fast. And folks, that's it. that's it for this month, and that's a lot of stuff to go through. So I'm gonna get to start building. You're gonna see kits from this show on the video on Wednesday. We're already gonna have these in construction. I'm not gonna tell you which ones because I want you to make sure you tune in to have a good time. As always, thanks for watching the workshop, and I will see all of you at the next review.